people get this, but we are in the fourth turning. It's very important for people to understand this is a phase that mankind goes through again and again, and they make it through it. And the choice is either the government and the oligarchs control everything and own everything, or we choose freedom. And I highly suggest people choose freedom. Okay, that's a really good question. It's a very perceptive question. The question is, will it collapse organically, or will somebody pull the plug? And I think the answer is it is collapsing organically, and the credit agencies will be blamed for it, but it was going to happen anyway. I'm hoping the economy collapses first, because if it's the other way around, it won't make any difference. My gut feel says I don't think there will be a world war, because the idiots in Washington are having to face the fact that every lie they've been telling for the last 18 months has floated to the surface, and now everyone realizes Ukraine was corrupt, Ukraine is corrupt, the money was all stolen, there are no weapons left to give them, and they have destroyed, and I mean Ukraine has destroyed Ukraine. There have been hundreds of thousands of soldiers killed for no purpose whatsoever. Putin and Lavrov were absolutely clear about what they were demanding, and they're going to get it in the end. So the question is, how stupid can Poland and NATO and the United States be? And I think they're at peak stupidity now. And I don't think there will be a world war, but Ukraine and NATO and the U.S. have lost catastrophically. If you go back to the Great Depression, home state mining was the leading stock on the Dow Jones from 1929 to 1937. Mining stocks, and this will be across the board, actual producers will have substantially more value. They have filled the can with cement, and every time they kick it now, there's more pain. And the internals of the financial system and the stock market are so dreadful, I don't believe it can be kicked further down the road. I've been saying for the last 6 months that I thought there would be a market crash in October, and I'm going to move that up a little bit. I thought the market would top in early September, like it did in 1929, but the market has clearly topped now. So I think the next 6 weeks, 2 months, there will be a clear crash. For people in the UK, and this is for anybody, I mean, you go to the UK, you can buy British sovereigns with no VAT, no tax, and you could sell them if you're a UK citizen with no tax. Now, in France, you can buy coins like the Russian ruble, like the German mark, like the French franc, like the British sovereign, coins that were legitimate coins in circulation. You could buy them with no tax, no premium. However, in France, you have to pay a 7% tax when you sell it. So the answer is basically every country is different, but some things are relatively similar across the board. Buying and selling silver is a bit of a problem outside the United States and Canada. You're going to pay a premium, and you're going to pay tax on it in most places. Same thing with platinum and palladium. So it's going to vary from country to country. Moving gold is actually very easy, because you could move it to the UK, or you could move it to France, or you could move it to Switzerland, and there's no duty and there's no tax involved. You couldn't move bars, but you could move gold coins that were in circulation. Well, let me raise an issue there because you just raised something that's important. The gold eagle never was a circulating coin. So you would pay VAT or duty on it in the UK and France because it would be treated as something other than a circulating coin. But the answer in general is it varies from country to country. Some things are very easy, buying sovereigns, buying French francs, buying Denmark's gold rubles. Those tend to be very easy. And I have a friend that just went to Russia and buying gold and silver at spot, is walk into a bank there. You have to educate yourself. Now, we have seen extraordinary changes in the world weather in the last 6 months. The narrative is it's climate change. What we need to do is lock people down. And it's absolute rubbish. And I posted a piece yesterday saying the 101 degree temperature in seawater off of Miami, the record flooding in Beijing, the record temperatures in Arizona and Texas, the temperatures in Europe, it all goes back to one thing. On January 15th, there was a volcano erupt in near Tonga. And it threw, it's a very funny number. If somebody wants to work it out, I would be very happy to have them work it out. There were 146 teragrams of water thrown into the atmosphere. And of course, water is a greenhouse gas when it's a gas. And that's what's causing all this extraordinary weather all over the world. It's not caused by humans. It's not caused by fossil fuel. It's not part of climate change. It's part of nature. So it's very important that people educate themselves. And there's lots of information available, but you got to go out there and find it. And you got to learn how to think for yourself. And I'm thrilled that people are actually waking up and realize, hey, wait a minute, the system's broken and we need to come up with a solution. We need to fix it.